This is a summary of the CPIC guideline for proton pump inhibitors, abbreviated to PPIs, and variation in the gene CYP2C19. This guideline was published in August 2020. This guideline provides recommendations for dexlansoprazole, lansoprazole, omeprazole, and pantoprazole. There is an increased potential for therapeutic failure of these PPIs in patients who are CYP2C19 ultra-rapid or rapid metabolizers, while patients who are CYP2C19 intermediate or poor metabolizers are potentially at an increased risk of experiencing toxicity. The guideline therefore recommends an increase in the starting dose for CYP2C19 ultra-rapid metabolizers and that a dose increase be considered for CYP2C19 rapid or normal metabolizers when treating Helicobacter pylori infections or erosive esophagitis. A dose reduction should be considered for chronic PPI therapy in CYP2C19 intermediate or poor metabolizers. The guideline also assigns a no recommendation to esomeprazole and rabeprazole. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB omeprazole and esomeprazole pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Omeprazole is used here as an example of the interaction between CYP2C19 and PPIs. PPIs are metabolized in the liver by CYP2C19. This metabolism inactivates PPIs. In CYP2C19 ultra-rapid or rapid metabolizers, metabolism of PPIs is increased. This increases the risk that the patient will fail to respond to PPI treatment. In CYP2C19 intermediate or poor metabolizers, the PPI inactivation is decreased. As a result, these patients experience an increased efficacy of PPI therapy and are possibly at an increased risk of toxicity. There are currently almost 40 defined alleles of CYP2C19, known as star alleles. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 or star 38 alleles, which are designated as normal function alleles. Diplotypes of CYP2C19 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Note that as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This can include rare, increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles, which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C19 alleles can also be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. CYP2C19 decreased function alleles are poorly characterized, and so the size of their impact on CYP2C19 function and drug metabolism is not well understood. As a result, patients carrying decreased function alleles are assigned as either a likely intermediate metabolizer or a likely poor metabolizer. The use of the term likely indicates that there is uncertainty in the phenotype assignment, but that it is still reasonable to use the recommendations for the confirmed phenotype. For example, it is reasonable to use the recommendations for CYP2C19 poor metabolizers for a patient assigned as a likely poor metabolizer. It is important to know that the CYP2C19 star 38 allele was recently designated as the reference allele for CYP2C19, rather than star 1. CYP2C19 star 38 matches the REF6 sequence for CYP2C19, while star 1 and many other alleles contain an I331V amino acid change. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for dexlansoprazole, lansoprazole, omeprazole, and pantoprazole, as shown in Table 2 of the guideline. Patients with a CYP2C19 ultra-rapid metabolizer phenotype will have decreased concentrations of PPIs and are at an increased risk of therapeutic failure. These patients should be given a 100% increase in the starting dose. This is an optional recommendation for all four PPIs. Patients with a CYP2C19 rapid metabolizer phenotype will have decreased plasma concentrations of PPIs and are at an increased risk of therapeutic failure. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose increase of 50 to 100% can be considered when treating Helicobacter pylori infection or erosive esophagitis. This is a moderate recommendation for lansoprazole, omeprazole and pantoprazole, and an optional recommendation for dexlansoprazole. Patients with a CYP2C19 normal metabolizer phenotype will have normal PPI metabolism. However, they may be at an increased risk of therapeutic failure compared to intermediate or poor metabolizers. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose increase of 50 to 100% can be considered when treating Helicobacter pylori infection or erosive esophagitis. This is a moderate recommendation for lansoprazole, omeprazole and pantoprazole, and an optional recommendation for dexlansoprazole. Patients with a CYP2C19 likely intermediate metabolizer phenotype are likely to have increased PPI concentrations. This likely increases PPI efficacy and potentially increases the risk of toxicity. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose reduction of 50% can be considered for patients on chronic therapy and where efficacy has been achieved. This is an optional recommendation for all four PPIs. Patients with a CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizer phenotype will have increased PPI concentrations. This increases PPI efficacy and potentially increases the risk of toxicity. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose reduction of 50% can be considered for patients on chronic therapy and where efficacy has been achieved. This is an optional recommendation for all four PPIs. Patients with a CYP2C19 likely poor metabolizer phenotype are likely to have increased PPI concentrations. This likely increases PPI efficacy and potentially increases the risk of toxicity. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose reduction of 50% can be considered for patients on chronic therapy and where efficacy has been achieved. This is a moderate recommendation for lansoprazole, omeprazole and pantoprazole, and an optional recommendation for dexlansoprazole. Patients with a CYP2C19 poor metabolizer phenotype will have increased PPI concentrations. This increases PPI efficacy and potentially increases the risk of toxicity. These patients can be given the standard starting dose. A dose reduction of 50% can be considered for patients on chronic therapy and where efficacy has been achieved. This is a moderate recommendation for lansoprazole, omeprazole and pantoprazole, and an optional recommendation for dexlansoprazole. CPIC assigns a no recommendation to a gene-drug pair where there is insufficient evidence, confidence or agreement to provide a recommendation to guide clinical practice at the time of publication. Based on the limited evidence which was available when creating the guideline, a no recommendation was assigned to esomeprazole and CYP2C19 and rabeprazole and CYP2C19. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to PPIs, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.